Discord channel. Well, let's see if it's going to be a good night or not.
You know, that pussy's pretty poggers.
That's what they say.
Yeah, that is what they say. Dude, our impressions are getting better. We were doing it a lot the other day. Because Paul, well, let me not talk about that anymore. Poggers. It's 50 pulls worth.
Inventory is full.
Everyone's so quiet tonight.
We're building for the storm, dude. Building for
That's
the storm.
True. Dude, I don't. Where the fuck is Paul's number? I don't remember, bro.
can't attack that.
I know a bio when I see one. Goblin products are built to blast.
Alright, I texted him. Dude, my stomach hurt. He fucking fell asleep. My man took a nap and he was fucking done.
Your interrupt dinner bell.
Well, called me and then proceeded to say fucking nothing. So I'm gonna.
He's in Discord.
Oh, he is. Okay, we're good. We're pogging. Push
the talk. Oh man.
Sorry, I laid down and fell asleep.
And you buttoned out.
I believe it. Sorry.
I'm joking.
My best friend, she's 23. She left her body in Harvard about.
This gang rings for days.
Sorry, I kept you waiting.
I want one. This is fucked up.
Dude, for that guy, I got the cloak.
I want one of those cloaks. This is fucked up.
Good job, that was a nice one, Stubby.
Wait, can I like roll and then like sell it for more?
Yeah, that's what I was just gonna ask.
Wait, what is this for?
Dude, what are we rolling?
It's the lowest
that
roll
ring if you wanna buy it.
You guys need to use it if we're gonna get it. I'm not reselling this.
Wait, use it on the alt. That's
okay. No, dude. Can you give it to main reader?
Hey, hey, Paul. Can't wait for the suffering.
Oh, that's the one I need, isn't it?
It's gonna be a good time.
I really want the pink headset from Razer with the kitty cat ears. I don't know why I haven't got it yet.
Didn't you buy that last night, Ruth?
No, I got the club or the ring.
Yeah, that's what
we're
is.
Talking about.
Oh. I thought we were rolling for this cape.
Vic, do you actually need it? Like, is that an upgrade for you? It's not a little bit too crazy.
I have the ring.
No, I know. I'm talking to Vic.
Oh, well, like, it's my best in slot, but I have a decently really good cloak.
We're talking about the ring still, dude.
I just said the same thing that you just said, and then Kesma corrected me, so I assumed we were talking about the cloak again. Sorry.
Hey, Rice.
She said I was asking Big.
Wait, can I just ask Rice a quick question real quick?
Yeah, what's up?
Do you need the BOE cape from here?
Good night.
I get a cauldron dance to me. So make sure you guys get the beast.
It's been out too long. I don't want it.
Did you guys? It's good to hear, Paul.
Yeah, but I added my own special ingredients. Just
getting in a little bit of prog. How far did you guys make it into the fight?
I stirred that cauldron with my stub.
Nobody touch it.
He's gonna drink all of it himself.
Drinks the whole cauldron.
So gross.
What phase did you guys make?
Paul has
to?
A new appreciation for stubs.
Found this new idol game I started playing today. It's called Idol Angels. There's these big titty anime angels. Oh my god. It's a good game.
What's it? It's gonna be rough. That's
Idol
brutal.
Angels.
What is it,
61
like
on Sabros? Okay. So through Frieda. That's not bad.
Getting
through Frieda's good.
Money on this game.
Like, it's like Cookie Clicker from what he's saying.
Yeah, it's basically you just sit there. It's an idle game. They fight for you.
My
Nice.
And then you progressively get ones with bigger boobies. Pretty cool.
I love America. Yeah, Stavros is considered phase two. Yeah, I kind of break the fight into six phases. But yeah, I mean, you can just break it into the three bosses, but I definitely feel different.
You
do different things
though,
on them,
like,
but
so.
I break it into like
videos too.
The boss and then the second half of each boss, you know? So I break it up just like in my own head.
Plus it's
that's
like
how
tap
I do
picks,
it.
Which is fine, you know?
I was gonna say, I used to send you feet pics all the time. What are you talking about?
Make sure you guys oil and armor kits.
Damn it, I just put the fucking oil on the wrong way.
Just switch hands.
It's a good thing they're only like 20 gold now, yeah.
That reaction.
The jumps take a while to get used to. Definitely. The jumps, getting all the cooldowns down. I mean, I'm fucking trashed here. I'm dropping my cooldown when it's time, you know? Like, it's big. Because it's, I don't know, this fight, it feels like there's just always a lot going on. Except on Frida. Frida, that doesn't feel like there's a lot going on. The rest of the fight, when there's all those ads around, it just feels like there's a lot going on. But there really isn't.
We're killing this first boy.
I don't know. At least that's how I feel about it. Like, it feels like there's more going on than there is. And it's overwhelming because of that, just because of how it feels.
Stickers, I want to clip those for you. Nothing would bring me more satisfaction.
Oh yeah, definitely. That's what's going to happen with the jumps. I mean, until, you know, you got to get everybody used to the, like, raid leader saying jump, and everybody jumps, and then let the healing cooldowns do their work, and then do it again.
It's fucked up.
100%.
Can't focus. Everyone's trying to turn me on.
And I'm trying to set my focus. We're misdirecting to Kezma, right?
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Jump. Jump. Jump.
Okay, that's a bit late. I make it work though. Like I said, we're gonna make it work.
Good.
Far back. Hey, padding is juicy, but you gotta remember that if you're padding on the bosses and they get healed, it doesn't count for the parse, so it doesn't matter. So don't pad there. Just whoop the fuck out the ads. Just cleave. Every time there's an ad on the group, get that ad damage in. Bro, give me a forward. Come on. Ah.
What's the total time for this?
Like, how long is the fight?
Just the dance.
Oh.
I definitely fucked up.
Go down, jump. 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 Mally, jump.
Thank you.
bad. I feel bad, guys. Sorry for a title.
I've Stavros.
Get clowns down. Jump. 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 Make sure we interrupt some creator. Side on you. Got Stavros. Matt. Careful you don't get charged.
10.
After the next one, we'll move back.
Stop, Rose.
Lance. Jump. Jump. Careful, stop. Stop, wait. Try to jump. Careful, careful, careful. Get some heals out. Use your headstones, guys. Jump. Hang on, make sure you jump one more time.
Taking that feather on the way back and put next to me.
Fine, can I stay now? I don't care.
Stack up first, I don't. Move the star a little bit further than it. Get clowns down here. Jump. Jump. Jump.
Having it close.
Interrupt some Frida. Interrupt some Frida.
Move back to Skull.
Moon. Get cooldowns down here at Moon. Jump. 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 Let's get lost. Stack up pin on square for nothing. Hold on, penetrates. Back up for recital.
Do you want to res on Bell?
Get him up quick, yeah. Are you getting cooldowns down? Jump. Jump. Jump.
Focus Sigma Klaus.
Let's go. Press credit. Wipe it. Bunch of people are still. We still need to push Stavros faster. We need to use potions on Stavros. We're not pushing fast enough. Also, when potions come back up, when we're on the second half of Stavros, we need to all pot.
Our quickest free to kill.
Yeah, we don't want that last like dance before Stavros dies, where we have to move. It messes up the timers.
Yeah, that was like a slightly slower than our average Stavros kill, but our Frida one was like so much faster. It was weird.
Who's letting her have it? Like
800k. Here is the beast.
Gonna get Lockrocks.
I'm gonna drop Cheese. Hopefully, we'll be pretty low. Make your repair.
And die, bitch.
Bounce down, jump, wait, jump, jump, don't make sure you jump one time, back up our recital, interrupt on Frida, star. Just like it. Don't get too far ahead of their side over your pass, you'll kill other people.
Holy cow, well, let me click the feast.
Some of the creed feast.
Oh my god.
Some of the creed armor kit.
Fuck it. Riding the fucking struggle bus over here, man.
Tended to sue our left from star, square.
No fucking full moon that time. Not shimmy right, shimmy right. Flushcraft. I'm trash.
Haunted the wrong one on accident.
There's two.
Jump. 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 Okay, I'm gonna jump. Kratos, I got the title. Where?
I've Severus.
Jump. Jump. Wait. Jump. Jump.
I had no class.
Got a man. Got a man.
Kill the attendant.
I can't have Stavros right now. Oh, he was hurting.
Stress is scary. Back up for recital. Star. Interrupts. Watch out for Star's discharge.
I have Stavros.
Just stay on Star and try and walk now. Let's get cooldowns down. Jump. 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 Plus. Big deeps on the class until the thing comes down. Interrupts on Frida. Kill the attendant and then get on the stone guard. Big deep on the stone guard. Set up for a title. Try to get on the attendant.
After this attendant in class is the focus when the gargoyle comes down.
Yeah, big deeps on the class here, interrupt Rita. Keep deep passing the class, push him to 50.
Tendon.
Glance down. Jump. Jump. Use your health stone. Jump. The timers are like super fucked right now.
Well, we took like way longer on state on the first part Stavros. Like we took forever to kill him, to get him to 50.
Well, something happened because when I came back, normally I hold my cooldowns just because we move, and he never casted anything to move. So
yeah, the problem was we were on Stavros for too long. We took like an extra like 20 seconds to push him to 50%. Like timers were way off.
someone was going real hard into the other guy. He was way lower than he normally is. Like someone did like 5% to him.
Make sure we're hitting the right target, guys.
Yeah.
Where are we supposed to be stacked there?
That one would have been triangle because we had the bosses on star.
Anyone live logging?
I forgot.
No.
Not always going to be the prettiest, like, you know, black and white where we're stacking. Just remember, you're always to the side of the boss, to the left. If, you know, if you're a tank here and facing the boss, you're always to the left. Doesn't matter where the boss is, just make sure you're always to its side. Because we try to keep them on markers, but it just doesn't always work that way.
I really wish they would stop, like, updating the Warcraft blogs uploader literally, like, twice a day.
Yeah, so this is going great so far. Oh man,
the one I just put in there, I just started, but after raid I'll fix it to where it has more.
Oh.
Yeah, Chaz, I think you might have been hitting the wrong target. Your top damage is the class.
That's cool.
I just saw he was low that pool.
Do you know Kesna armor kit?
Those are so expensive, man. I don't know.
10 now. Square. Count. 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 Agony, three jump here. Push down this case. We're probably gonna get our title pretty quickly after this, if you're ready.
Potions are up in 30. Attendant.
Star, you're pulling down a triangle. Path, make sure you don't. Potion's here to finish power us. Path jumping out. Just hold here, we don't need to move back. Go ahead, time that quickly. Stack up tight for recital, man. Stack up, stack up, stack up. He's gotta stack up first item. We're off on Stavros still. We need to push him before that dance that's killing us. To make sure you're using potions when they come back up on Stavros. Here, lift him. If your flask goes under 10 minutes on a reflask. Alright, everybody's ready. Timber's going up. Go down. Jump. 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 Back up for a sail. Back to the recital. Get close down now. Back up our recital. Back Alright. Careful of the charge on Stavros, you're ready for the ad here. After lunch, we're moving back. Cooldown's down on square. Jump. Jump. Wait. Alright, jump. Push down right there yet. Good. Is it just me or we're way fucking ahead right now?
We're way ahead right now.
Okay. Should be interesting.
It's normally 2 seconds on Dark Recital. At least last night it was always 2 seconds.
I don't think we're ahead because my combust actually came up at the right time.
Well, the right, timer. Potions are supposed to like come up like when Stavros comes back, and that's like.
Yeah.
Potions aren't up for another like 40 seconds.
Typically, the potions have 20 seconds left on them when Stavros comes back.
We improved the recital timer by 3 seconds.
Get the recital, stack up, press big. Good man. Good man. Get cooldowns down here by man. Alright, jump. Jump. You need this quick. Jump. Interrupt some braid in the back. Braid buffer bag. Back. Big push here, guys.
I have Severus.
We're gonna get the waltz here and the recital be ready. Moon. Get the moon, get glance down when we get the moon. Alright, jump. 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 Get lost out now, big deeps. I'll move back once the dancers go up. Move back.
Giving her up.
Stack up, man, stack up. Kill skull and then axe. Big deeps on axe, stack up for recital. Panda. Use your health center for a little here. See it cooldowns down when they come up. Axe, you can get your AMZ now.
Yeah.
Alright, guys. Jump. 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 Careful, careful, careful. Big deeps on the class here, guys. Hang on, Mal, I still need to jump. Kill the ad, then push the class quick.
Should I take this spider eyes?
Yes, yeah. Finish that ad, guys. Use your health stones and pots here. Don't die. Don't die. Push the class 1%. Health stone guard as you can.
Fleshcraft if you can, everyone.
But no B-reses are gonna be super clean.
The next stone guard needs to die incredibly fast.
Stop this nonsense! You have disgraced this gathering long enough!
Get cooldowns out. Jump. Interrupts, jump. Jump. necessary, make sure you don't.
Knockback coming.
Big clamp. Stack back up quick, stack back up. Big deeps on the stone guard. Vital, then the attendant. Finish the attendant. Stack up. Big deep on the class here, guys. Interrupts.
We gotta pull the boss back and stack to the right.
Stack up first, I don't guys. Stack up first, I don't. After the recital, group up for cooldowns. Group up for cooldowns. Jump. 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 Stack up for recital. Stack up, stack up, stack up. Kill the attendant, guys. Ten on the class. Nice.
Let's go.
Let's go. Oh, nice job.
Good job.
Stupid Macabre.
Oh my god. I died and I just put my head down. I was like, oh my god.
Yo, that conduit seems pretty good.
I didn't get a heal for like 8 seconds. Come on, guys.
I was like super clean. I saw cheat death up.
I didn't, dude. I was fucking kiting. I was everywhere trying not to get hit by that stone guard.
Ooh, I got two potencies. Oh, I got the one that you might actually change what you use for BM. Oh no.
The bloodline.
Good job, guys.
Yeah, I just got a 226 of it.
We got lucky because we're never going to this again.
And I got the other one too, the interrupt one.
We actually had a lot of good fucking parses on that.
It was a quick kill.
I died. Mine probably dropped real bad.
Yours isn't bad.
Not a zero.
Yeah, yours is a three.
Nice. Top three, right?
I don't know exactly if I can trade it, but I'm going
there
to
there we
roll
fucking
it.
Go. Oh my god, my stream died.
Tradable.
Oh no, it's dead.
Oh no, it does say soulbound.
Fucking rip.
I didn't put my splinter in my other socket, broke. Probably. My
and
other.
Fucking pole didn't tell me anything. Oh, that
rip,
is painful.
You guys repair on the way up the sludge.
That's painful. I don't have the recording of it.
I mean, Macabre is such an annoying trinket to use, anyways.
Nobody got leather boots. I'm spinning out of control, not knowing which way to go.
Can we go back marksman now?
Probably for this fight because you can fit your burst in that little window better.
I guess
not that bad. It's actually easier
the stream
than
like froze.
While we're learning the fight,
so I don't know the recording of it, but we killed it, so it's dead.
It might be better.
It fucking sucks. I'm really
it's a lot faster fight, so it's quicker pulls instead of you know 8 minutes.
Oh thank God.
I heard you fuck up your combust. You just wiped the red.
Where'd you hear that? Mage Discord.
Oh, that was definitely me. Yeah, big rip, honestly. Yeah, look, it's still frozen. I don't know what is wrong with this capture device. It's like a million
Hunters are gonna get a 20% buff overall next week. Oh, that's gonna be great.
Like, it's just painfully bad. It's
oh,
so
I do.
Hot.
It's the only reason I come back. Maybe they'll do it.
Yeah, I'm big sad.
To manifest
I'm big sad
that,
you missed it, man.
Good job, guys. That's awesome. We got that down.
Big 95th percentile.
Where we have
parts,
like the
though,
most random the kills. We'll be like pulling, and then all of a sudden we're like, okay, it's dead.
Was absolutely slapping the boss as hard as I could.
But like when I sim it, it says it's better, but I ain't dealing with that bullshit.
Yeah, I mean it's real high up there for BM, but I don't know if I want to use it.
There's a lot of classes.
Isn't it like the easiest for BM to collect?
Yeah, it is the easiest for BM to use, but it's still a pain in the ass.
The thing is when you sim it, you gotta understand that it's like perfect sim, you know? Like you're always picking up every shade.
For BM, you are.
Yeah,
no, I mean towards pathogen. Yeah. Like it's, they're definitely. I mean, it's definitely not best in slot for unholy.
Yeah.
Quantum device and power crystal is much better. The macabre is very annoying to use. I'm telling you.
I mean, especially if you roll it, I'll roll it for it.
I can actually trade mine.
Literally hot fucking garbage for unholy. Don't you dare take that back.
Yeah, it's terrible. I mean, I can roll mine actually. It says it's available for trade, so I'll roll it. I mean, you can go for it, Path, but if you use it, it's not a good choice.
No, I'm gonna make fun of him. Every time he uses it, don't use it. I'm serious.
You're gonna look at the logs and look at the uptime?
Mm-hmm. I'm just gonna meme on him all. I'm just gonna miss messages.
I had to
him
use it
mean.
When I
don't do it.
I had to use it like during heroic progression, and
oh,
it was a terrible.
It's definitely not a progression trinket. It's a
I guarantee you, even the 210 quantum device is freaking like probably is a thousand times better than that hunk of garbage.
It's a definitely don't use on this fight.
Well, quantum is so nice for unholy because you want to slingshot as much power as you can into Apocalypse and Army of the Dead. So having a trinket on demand like that is huge.
Might be fine for the next fight. To set things up here.
No,
I'll just give it to you, Dino, since you won the trade.
Oh yeah. I'm not using it on this fight, but next fight I might actually use it. Mm-hmm. Quantum for this fight, definitely.
Don't you have a
well,
quantum device, Path?
To the people watching.
Yep.
The Stone Legion's actually pretty much as good as you're gonna get in a raid setting. Stone Legion and Quantum. Anima Field Emitter is another good one.
His speed too, I forgot. Oh my god.
I think getting a 226 overwhelming power crystal is your best bet though.
You just need to go back and get some arcano crystals. Attack forge up to this level.
You do not want a 226 power crystal. If you're talking a path, that's not the second trinket you want to run. You either want to run Stone Legion if you're in a stacked group, or you want to run one of the passive
ones.
Well,
that's what I was saying.
Double on
uses
trash run only. It's really
I mean if you can use both double on use, it's gonna be the most damage output in the best setting. But yeah, in running Stone Legion when you have a group of Stone Legions, way better. For quality of life, I would never run double on use either.
After watching this fight a bunch, I don't know if I'm ready for it, you guys.
You're telling me, you know how hard this boss hits on heroic on the tanks? I'm freaking butt clenching the whole time. I don't know what it's gonna feel like.
Can't wait for everyone to get mad at each other for stacking wrong.
All right,
first.
Guys. So, basically, the biggest difference is the way the whole fight works. So.
Oh.
God damn it.
Where's the lantern at?
He has a new ability that will put like a little brown circle under every player in the raid. It'll like pop up a spike under you. So you have to like be near your chain partner, but you have to be spread out slightly so that you're not hitting each other's spikes. There's not one big range group in Mythic. It's just, you know, a bunch of groups of two everywhere, and you just spread out slightly for the spikes. Every single person will be linked. Cam, you count as melee for this fight, so you'll be linked to a melee the whole fight. We have an even number of melee, so we'll be none of the range should get linked to the melee as long as no one's dead. Axie, we get linked together, so make sure that you stay near me. I'll make sure I don't use my leap to kill you. The other thing that happens that's new is when he charges a pillar, it spawns four circles on each like face of the pillar. If you look at the picture, that's basically how it's gonna work. Is ranged will be in that like top left corner for the first pillar, and then melee will be on the right corner, so ranged will be on skull, melee will be to the right of that. The tanks will be here behind the pillar, and then the hunters and whoever their hunters are linked with will be on this face. You need to look at the picture because there's not nearly enough marks for this to like to be marked up for every single pillar. And then it's basically the same for pillars 2 and 3. And then on pillar 4, because sludge is coming from the other side of the room, it's reversed. So on pillar 4, ranged will be on square, the tanks will be on circle, and the hunters and links will be over here on this side, and then the melee will be here. It's gonna take a little bit of getting used to. Basically, when you soak the circle, it then splits into two smaller circles, and you have to soak those circles as well. Axie, for ours, because we're the only ones that are only two people, so it's super important that we both go different ways for the small circles. When we're in our circles, we'll each stand to one side of the circle, like the left or right, and then, you know, you just go to the split that is on the side that you've picked. Because there's not time to adjust once the small ones spawn, if we both go to the same one.
Okay.
Other than that, there's a lot more damage. For Chain Slam, we only want it to hit 4 people. If it doesn't hit 4 people, the boss will charge instantly, which is bad. But we don't want to drag the whole raid in. So the way it's going to work is normally we do both boomkins, but Swizzle's not feeling well and we needed to adjust the melee. The match. So for today, it's gonna be the Boomkin and Stubby are gonna be the furthest from the boss at all times with whoever they are linked to. If it gets super unlucky and they link to each other, then we'll just have, I guess, Chrono be far. But those, so Simba, Stubby, and the two people they get linked to will be in the Chain Slams, basically. It'll target the furthest group back. Those two groups of people will go in the Chain Slam. They get thrown into melee. At melee is when the actual damage happens. So that's where you can use, like, you know, some damage reduction cooldowns. Let me get the cooldowns posted in Artina.
Who are the two that are the farthest out again?
Simba and Stubby and whoever they're linked with. Normally it'd be both Boomkins and whoever they're linked with, but we were a little bit weird on comp today. Alright, the note should be out. Cooldowns. Please make sure you know when you're using your cooldowns. They're on roars and it gazes the charge. But yeah, it's not a super hard fight. Everyone just kind of has to learn the dance to it. On the second stomp, I believe it's the second stomp, or no, the first stomp each time, there's gonna be the like, the spikes right after. Ranged, you have to make sure you're not right on the edge of stomp because melee needs the edges to use for their spikes. Because melee is just barely gonna get out of stomp and they're gonna like split to do their spikes. Let's get a summon on gate. Damsy is like literal garbage on this fight. It's like pretty much all physical damage and nobody is stacked.
Well, the entire fight is physical damage, so yeah.
There's a little bit of nature damage, isn't there?
Nope. Every single ability is physical.
I thought one of the abilities was...
This is the one fight where Death Knights literally don't have the utility.
Bro, Colossal Roar is sonic damage.
I think it still counts that as physical instead of magical. I don't know
what that means. I'm just saying that's
sonic damage. Sonic damage is a type of physical damage. World of Warcraft is really
sonic
stupid.
Sonic the Hedgehog, dude.
What about Tails damage, dude?
I'm freaking terrified of this fight. I don't know why.
If we had more range, we would be setting some of the melee. This is like the most melee unfriendly fight of the tier.
Yeah.
This is what we're gonna go with for tonight, and then next week hopefully we can get the comp straightened out a little bit.
This boss hurts on heroic. I don't know what this is gonna feel like on epic.
It's gonna be rough for you.
For the tanks, yeah, on heroic I feel like I'm trying to live the whole time.
Is any trash up still?
I like how you throw that. It'll be rough for you because I'm a vengeance demon hunter.
So it's 6 melee path because holy paladins count as melee, which is why we brought in a melee over one of our range, because otherwise we'd have a range getting linked to melee every time, which is really annoying. I could show you the truth. Yeah, those weak auras that big link, they're really useful. Especially the pretty spread one.
Everyone click them at the same time and make big lag out.
They're not that big.
That's what she said.
Alright, let's get some buffs out. Get a couple pulls in to start seeing how it's coming before we take our break. I would not recommend using potions on this fight until we learn it a bit more. And I'm also not going to be dropping feasts. Because I'm pretty sure there's going to be at least a few wipes where people just break their chains instantly.
Yeah, probably.
So, by the way, for everyone who doesn't know, since normally you're used to stacking, the way chains work is we'll put a red arrow above somebody else's head before the chains actually link up. That is your chain partner. You cannot be super stacked on this fight. You just have to go run to your chain partner. And remember, Simba and Stubby should always be the furthest away from Sludge Fist with whoever they are chained to.
So, like, where do I stand? I'm confused.
Just in the back of the group.
Just, like, behind everybody else, yeah.
Just notice where all the range are going to be and then just stand behind them. Just make sure you're the furthest away.
It just means you and Simba and then whoever is getting chains.
So they can run to me. I don't have to go find them.
Yep. You should still probably, if they're super far away, you should run to them and then back up because there's only so much time before the chain actually links. And if you're just too far, it'll break instantly. Okay. And there's a picture in Discord. You're always in the one that says Hunters plus Link, which is the same one for the first three, and then it's a different one on the fourth pillar. So, like, it's always facing Sludge. It's like, the front left for the first three, and then it's the, like, I guess, back right for the fourth one. I would just look at the picture. It's more descriptive than that.
Well, what about, like, the other ones? Like, what about 2 and 3?
That's the same. 1, 2, and 3 are the same assignments.
Okay.
Yeah. It only changes on 4 because on 4 Sludge Fist is on the other side of the room. Like, if you look at where Sludge Fist is on each charge.
Yeah, I see what you're saying.
Yeah, because on 4 we have him on that side of the room, and then the tanks have to, like, be on this side of the pillar, otherwise, you know, he runs into us. So it mixes it up, but... Yeah, the Hunter plus Link is the Hunters plus whoever is linked to the Hunters. So just make sure you know if you are linked to Dino or Big, because you have a different assignment than the rest of the range.
What if they get hooked up to me or Simba?
That's fine. That has nothing to do with the pillar, so okay.
Well, do me and Simba go to the Hunters, or do the Hunters come to me and Simba?
They would come to you, but this is for when Sludgefist charges the pillar. You have to go to a specific spot. So when Sludgefist hits a pillar, it spawns 4 circles around the pillar that have to be soaked. And then those circles, once they're soaked, split into two smaller circles each that also have to be soaked. The Hunter plus Link is for the soaking. The thing that you and Simba are doing is for Chain Slam.
Yeah, no, I missed that part, sorry.
Yeah, no problem.
God, Stubby.
Unacceptable.
Just waiting for Cam to get back online, I don't know. But,
how are we gonna one-shot this?
He logged, he went offline, logged on, said S in chat, and then went back offline. Oh, they have to, if you relog, it's definitely not going to let you get them. You'd have to have them linked again after relogging. Can you link them again, Big?
So,
when you hit the
I think
thing,
Sludge is like, an easier boss to kill than Council.
So you can move in after.
Actually, I don't know. I don't know if I actually think
move,
that.
Like, into the
I think that maybe
it,
your raid has to
once
play
the circle,
slightly
like,
better
once
on
it
Sludge
hits, like the soak hits, then it splits into two small.
So, you gotta like play a little bit better. But I actually think that Sludge is gonna go down faster, just because like, if you kill it or not, the fight ends at like 5 minutes and 20 seconds, right? Well, I mean, we had probably fucking 20 or 30 or 40 wipes 10 minutes into a fight on the last one. This one is way worse for Death Knight. I am straight up middle of the pack on this fight. And Unholy on the last fight isn't as good as Frost, but I just don't have the stuff to play Frost. I'm hoping that I'll get my shit together and I'll have the stuff ready to go for Frost for Stone Legion Generals after this. And that's going to be big.
10k split between everyone, then I'll in it, which is
big,
not that big,
big
of a deal.
Pump,
and then the small
but,
ones do like
yeah.
2.5k to each person in them. So it's okay.
I mean,
it's like
kind of nice
so,
because...
But if any of them get missed...
Yeah, you know, we had the warrior who was cleaving really hard. We had the we had decent cleave on our adds, so it wasn't too bad. Plus we had the Blood Death Knight doing all the extra gripping and stuff like that. The ads went down reasonably fast. So I don't know if Frost really would have been that much better.
Cooldown timings
Holy
are really tight on this
on Council.
Make sure you, like,
but,
you
know, it was definitely nice that I was in there to just pump the bosses down.
This fight
down.
Is, like, incredibly scripted in that sense. Like, all the abilities. There's no spell queuing. Like, everything happens at exactly when it's supposed to.
Wish the next fight was like that.
I'm actually gonna go ahead and check.
We're extending next week, right?
Yeah, yeah, we're extending until we have CE.
Yep.
You mean until next year, right?
Exactly.
I hope we kill the Nathras before the next year comes out, dude.
Hmm.
Yeah, that would be cool.
I'm so toxic. I just can't help myself.
What drops Labor Day?
Day of labor. Everyone's having their babies.
Are you swinging on pathogen?
When is Labor Day? I don't even know when that is.
Amira, sorry.
Alright, guys, we're gonna get a full timer. We're basically gonna be tanking him a little further back than where he is now for the first one.
Yeah, 95 is pretty big, especially like progression.
Remember,
kill.
Kind of loose spread.
95.
And find your chain partners when they go out.
Really sexy. Like, definitely feel good about that. I even died at the very end, to be honest with you. I died like at like 1 or 2%.
Ready for ship? Chain slam soon. Four people in the back should be in it. Keep going for now. Should be a lot. lot of like things that are obviously whites, but we gotta go towards Chris Pillar, Pixie.
Oh yeah, I forgot. I completely forgot.
So can you put someone else other than me on the far back? Because I was at the back trying to be behind everybody, and I was out of range of the boss.
I mean, other people need to be closer.
I forgot to play marksman.
You guys can just release her on back. It's not that far.
Probably.
Oh, yeah.
Her parents in the way.
I wasn't really paying too much attention to my rotation. I was just hitting all my buttons and looking.
I'm actually like still
if your chain breaks,
trying to go through Warcraft logs to figure out exactly how I want to play this fight.
I'm gonna break our chain, right? Oh, I'm not gonna get chained to you.
A turtle or something?
I'm gonna turtle and run away. If you karma the boss and I break your chain, does it do all that damage to the boss?
No.
Oh, god damn it. I need to move these feasts. Why'd you just let me drop that?
Damn, dude, I was about to say. I thought you said no feasts.
I saw it. He was like, yeah, we're killing this. This pool.
Yeah, that was it, dude. That was close. We almost had him.
At the very, right when the chains went out, I saw a couple.
Yeah, I still hit a pillar, okay?
Yeah, just make sure on that second one we run towards the pillar. I'm so used to just running out anyway and then leaping towards the pillar, but yeah.
I got caught up by you getting smacked by the slam. So.
I wasn't worried about that. It doesn't do that much damage to me, and I can jump to negate the knockback, so.
Yeah, I just... I'm like, oh crap.
Just want to confirm, was that the wrong...
That was the wrong pillar, yes.
Okay.
Yeah, I just went brain dead for a minute and just slammed him into something.
No, we were trying to move over to our spot, and then all of a sudden...
Yeah, it was the wrong pillar. It's fine.
God, quit making me relive it, guys. Jeez.
So where I'm at right now next to this feast is my max range on the boss, just so y'all know.
Yeah, other people need to move closer and, like, spread out a bit. Like, arc around the boss, kind of. Let's go to the right on the stop of the exit. Oh god, I don't think there's any space there. Fuck. Yeah, that's not good.
We lived.
I'm stunned though. My chain's slim. Had to move him a little bit to be able to lose space. Remember, we're gonna be charging into the pillar after this next roar. We're also not linked anymore because we broke our chain, so.
Asthma.
Don't be in front of the pillar. You ready to scope?
Oh,
this one's ours, Axie.
Atlee, you got.
Axie over here.
Oh, okay, I see what you.
Alright, so everyone has to have that, the leader slash follower, because if you know you're linked to either me or Dino, it is imperative that you move.
I see what it looks like now, the soak.
Yeah, we'll always be on the same one, except on the fourth pillar, we're on kind of the same one, but like facing the other side of the room, basically. Ours are the ones that have that like tank icon on the picture, the shield. Okay.
I wonder how they think up this shit. Like these dudes who fucking like think up these strats. Like...
Looks like Kezma needs to restart, so let's just go ahead and take our break. We're just gonna sit here. Should be back in 10. If you haven't watched a video on this fight, I strongly recommend just giving one a quick glance over, because it looks like a lot of people don't know the mechanics at all. So. Please make sure you do that.
I mean, what we've just seen is the whole fight, right?
I mean, kind of, but like, it'd still be good to just get like at least skim through a video and see how things are supposed to move. right back. I need to get some stuff done on break.
Debating about that. I'm really debating. Kind of curious.
I know it's cheating. A lot of these logs.
Are using the inscrutable on pull. Which I get, except.
Pretty sure hunters and mages both have.
I just don't know. I don't know. There's a lot to it.
Marksman hunter can go further back.
See, because I could. Technically speaking, I could inscrutable the first boom.
Once you have enough mastery, is further than boom.
I can't army the first and the third. I have to army the on pull, and then I have to army here at the end.
It scales with our mastery.
Actually, I think here's the end.
So, max range doesn't really matter because, like, your partner is not also going to be someone who has the same max range as, like,
I fucking hate inscrutable.
You just have to be in the back. Everybody else needs to be closer.
I hate it because of how big a damage defense the two buffs are. And if it's not during lust, then you're only guaranteed one of your top two instead of your top stat. And like the difference between them is insane. So, I don't know. We'll see. I'm tempted to try army everything on pull.
Y'all want to hear the story about how Grant
the problem is that I definitely think, I don't know.
But he sent it to Florida instead of my house.
I don't, because you do double damage on the pillar, right? So having inscrutable for the pillar would be nice, but I don't do double damage the rest of the time. I think it's better. I think it's just better to use on pull with the army. And then just hold it for the final
one.
It's tempting to try and do some weird, funky shit, but it's just not worth it. Well, because like if I use it on the first pillar, I'm gonna get it back just in time for the final pillar. But the downside is that I'm only going to have Apocalypse, Dark Transformation, and Blight running. I'm not gonna have my A-bomb limb. I'm not gonna have my Blood Fury. I'm not gonna have army. So I don't know that that equates to double the damage, especially not once you consider the duration of it.
He's like, let me talk to your manager. He was trying to get all the way up to Mr. Walmart.
I think I'm just going to do mine on pull, but this one...
Someone's going to be happy.
I did see that the top...
Canceling it.
The top parse is actually using a simple Gladiator's badge as a second trinket.
It's like, yeah, okay, buddy.
So he's popping the sinful on these three pillars. You know, that's what he's doing. He's sinful, sinful, sinful. Especially and then probably 20 like seconds that, after this pillar, he's still getting another sinful. He's getting four uses, which isn't bad.
I could understand it more if it was something you could cancel and reorder, but something that you just can't do that with, like... That's
in comparison to Anim's, which I'm just hoping I get a proc on the pillar.
It was funny that Walmart,
which I mean is big if I get the proc on the pillar, but if the proc's not on the pillar, it's worth half the value.
It's even processed, you know?
But it's also fucking 13
gotta
even
be something stupid like in their system.
Yeah, Sinful's main stat. Sinful's main stat. It's crit trinket.
The cheapest I can find one for 700, right?
It's actually it's the best trinket for Frost Obliteration.
So glad I got one.
Which I wish that was like the big brain play for this spec, you know? One minute burst spec. And it just doesn't perform, I guess. I mean, the logs just don't support it. Like, part of me wants to fucking try it. Like, part of me wants
to. More or less, if the game's on PC, I'm gonna buy it on PC.
What everybody tells me to do here.
There's a couple games, though, that are come out for PS5 only. They're pretty badass.
Because, like, if I could do that with the.
I think we should just take with the obliteration,
it would be crazy.
Celebrate killing
me. Right? I could, like, obby and just shred the boss and be happy. But,
I mean, the best part is the fact that this fight's not as long, so we're gonna get. That'll probably be a more pull kill than council, but a lot less time spent.
Well, all I hear is it's gonna be more expensive because we're gonna die more. That's what I'm hearing.
I doubt it.
No pain, no gain.
I doubt it's even gonna take as many kills as council did. this fight, once you get past like the first pillar, it's the same fight. The fight doesn't change.
I mean, I hope it doesn't, but other guilds like our caliber have more pulls on this than council.
Those guilds are dumb. And they suck. And we suck too, but not as much as them, because we're going to kill a bit faster.
We do not suck, okay?
We definitely suck, but...
We're great.
I suck.
My friend's guild on Sire right now, and like, I feel like they jumped from like 7 to 9 really fast.
Stone Legion's the hardest fight in the whole raid.
I feel like they killed it really fast.
Did Stone Legion get nerfed?
Yeah.
I mean, it's gotten fixed a couple of times. It hasn't gotten fully nerfed yet. Yeah. It's just gotten easier.
Yeah. It's gotten a lot easier than it was.
You mean they fixed the fight and made it work how it's supposed to work?
The pull count's been dropping for sure.
Yeah, with Stone Legion, that's a heavy pull fight. That's the hardest fight, probably.
This boss is literally supposed to be pretty much the same fight the whole time.
Yeah, well, the nice part about Sludge Fist versus Council is there's not as much like RNG and like racing timers as much as Council. And just like the variables that can really be annoying. There's no like crazy overlap.
The big nerf to everything, probably.
I'll tell you what's annoying. The fact that this isn't a two-handed obliteration fight. That's what's annoying.
I honestly do not think we will see any like full raid nerfs until April. Maybe mid-April.
Yeah, a couple weeks.
I think they'll nerf the bosses we've already killed maybe a little bit.
I don't think they'll nerf those that much anymore. Maybe Council, but
Council
like...
will get a little bit more of a nerf, but I don't think they'll touch the last three until like end of April, maybe mid May.
Are you guys ready for the cicadas who live in the cicada area? It's about to happen.
I just moved away from North Carolina, so I'm very grateful for that. You don't get any sleep when that happens.
Oh, no, you don't. It's like 2 weeks, or no, more than that. It was like 5 weeks of no sleep.
Yeah, it's a long time. It is a very long time.
What is it?
Cicadas.
Are they like bugs or something?
Yeah, they come out. Well, this... What, it's been like how many years since they've come out?
I think they're 7 years.
Alright.
Do I'm your back. Best guess and it'll pop up probably. I can't remember how to spell it either.
C-I-C-A-D-A.
It's like a kick it a.
Yeah, I like the overlays, like man.
Hopefully this is the hopefully it's the right thing. Hopefully it's not porn. Okay, good.
Whew. No, it is. Yeah, they're freaking terrifying looking.
Oh fuck, it's like a big ass fly with
They'll land on you, man. They'll freaking and they won't hurt you, but I mean it's big. It's not little. Yeah.
You'll go through like a thing of like a window wiper fluid in like a week.
Yep. Killing all of them.
Yeah.
Never moving to North Carolina.
He's not well, it's like pretty much a lot of the east, but the thing is it's like he said, like if you go and lean on a tree, your hand's probably gonna be covered in cicadas.
Yeah.
Are you talking about cicadas?
Yeah, cicadas, yeah. Right? Yeah. Well, supposed to be. It's obviously just an anticipation, but yeah, it's supposed to be.
I wanna see if the widgets actually are working though. That's one thing I'm kind of curious about.
Here's what a tree will look like once it starts. The base of a tree.
Yep.
Like I wish I could get somebody to follow right now so I could see if it works. Because it's supposed to pop up with this bad boy.
Like this.
Oh, it doesn't work there. Let's see about here.
We all of this.
I think.
All right, guys. Break's over. So we really need to work on being closer to the boss. The healers need to have range of the tanks, and like you need to let the four people who are supposed to be in the back be behind everyone. You guys just like want to be out of stomp range and spread out. You can also be like, you don't need to be on that side of that pillar. You can be, some groups can be over here too. Like, you can kind of just spread out around the room. But you want to be close to Sludgefist still, so you want to like spread out in front of this pillar here, kind of some people over here in the middle. And then just have those two people who are supposed to be in the back with whoever they're linked to further back. It doesn't have to be like crazy far behind either. It's just whoever is the furthest back gets targeted by Chain Slam. And we're just trying to bait it so it's easy for just one extra group to go stacking it so it only hits four people. Because the Chain Slam, when it hits those four people, it's also going to put a bleed on them. That's not like split damage. So the more people it's on, the harder it is to heal through that bleed. So, like, already, like, some of you guys need to move up. Like, you're too far back. Stop being back there.
That's right. I have a 40-yard range, and I need to be behind you.
And you guys also just need to be closer, like, so the healers can heal the tanks.
So should we do a thing where, like, when melee runs out, they actually, like, run out to, like, this side? Or is that not a thing we can do?
The melee just runs to the very edge. As long as you're not on the very edge of stomp, melee will have room.
Okay.
Alright, everybody's ready. The number's going up.
I don't know why you would ever want fire bugs to kill Kakita.
Buff hand.
Oh, no.
What the heck?
You gotta like. Yeah, well, not enough people got hit by Chain Slam. Sorry, that's why I tried.
Yeah, we needed to get in that Chain Slam bell.
Simba died, so.
You guys have to get to your partners. Like.
Simba died, so it was just me and Dino. And then Hysteria went to get in it, but his partner didn't.
Yeah, we were the closest to the Chain Slam, so we just wanted to go ahead and step in that.
Okay.
Normally, it's just whoever's linked to Stubby and Simba, but Simba and Kazuma died because they didn't get together with their chain.
I was so confused. Like, did I forget a slam or something?
I was like, I'm not ready to go soak. What's going on?
I was not ready either.
Also, don't forget to save cooldowns.
Everybody needs to be closer to the boss because the people who are standing in the back are too far for the healers to heal the tanks. So, like, Kazuma got linked to Simba, and you guys were too far back and didn't have range. Like, you don't need to be at your max range if you're the two people in the back. You just need to be behind the rest of the group, and everybody else needs to be a lot closer. You guys need to stop trying to be in the back of the fucking room. Like, not you, Stubby. I'm talking about the rest of the range. Like, you guys need to be closer so that the people who are supposed to be behind the range can be behind you without being 40 yards away. The only place you don't want to stand is directly next to the pillar, because you don't want to drop rubble on the pillar. But you can be, like, up here in this corner, you can be between these two pillars, like, as long as you're not, like, in between them, but you can be, like, up to the front in between them. Like, you just gotta work on spreading out a little bit better. And you don't have to be crazy spread out, either. Like, just enough for there to be room for the spikes to not hit everybody.
How big is this spike? That's the circle around it, right?
Yeah. The little, how like, round.
That's what, like, 5 yards? Not even 5 yards?
It's 4 yards. But you guys gotta let the people who are supposed to be in the back without making them be, like, 50 yards away, because the tanks are on the other side of the boss, and the healers need to be able to reach the boss. Or the tanks. There's only a few fools in, like, but we really, like, you just gotta be closer.
And that, can you healers hit the tanks from, like, these tiles here?
So, for the chain slam, you guys need to make sure the Simba and Stubby groups are in the back, and those two groups go into the chain slam.
Can I get someone back real quick?
Hell no.
Please? Okay, someone's left eye to see the realms you've seen.
Try to group up with your healer, like, as close to the melee as much as you can.
Is everybody still, like, too far back?
Not everyone, but a few people still are.
Just make sure that you're not so close that you don't leave the melee room to get out of stomp. the edge of the stomp needs to be to clear for the melee to run out to.
Like, if you guys look at where these skeletons are, you guys can stand right here, ranged. Where this,
the melee
this,
like, really remains, only needs, like,
that's plenty of room.
The edge of the stomp. Yeah. Like, they're not trying to run very far away.
Like, you guys can almost scoot way the fuck up here and be right where these dead bodies are, basically. Except the people have to be in the far back.
And those people should only be slightly further back. You know, it's not really the far back, it's just the furthest back.
I think I was on, like, these tiles and then, like, probably by this skeleton.
Taking something back.
Not sure it's gonna work. It looks like I might already have one pending, but in the chat.
My game, like, DC'd as I hurt out.
Already pending. Relogging. Sometimes fixes that. Get a shout, man. Waiting on path. Good. For the next stop. We're going for its pillar next. Yep. Be ready after he hits the pillar, soak your sides. A little better till that point.
Because I was with Dino, I go to the hunter one.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
So got, like, we got all the big soaks, we just missed some of the small soaks. You just gotta make sure. I can show you what, like, the tanks do, and that might help you a little bit too.
I was just making sure I went to the right place.
Yeah, I'm just saying for whoever missed. So here, if you guys want to come by the square pillar real quick, Zaxi gets up here, I'll show you what the tanks do. Or I guess we'll use the pillar we actually use up here. So basically the circle, you know, takes up basically the whole face. We spread out like this. That way we know who's going to go to what side. And then it splits and we just, like, step a little bit to get into the one that's, like, on the side you're kind of spread out towards. So just spread, like, a little bit in the circle. That way you know which direction you're going to go when it splits into the small ones. And that should help you. But there should also be at least like four people in every other one. Like, there's four people in the Hunters plus Link one, and then there's six people like in the melee one, and then two in the tank, and then everybody else in the ranged one, so we shouldn't really be missing any. The Hunters plus Link one is probably the smallest.
I'd like to move stuff to the side one. It doesn't have to be the same person you're with, right? Or
no, it doesn't. It's just somebody has to soak it. It doesn't matter who.
Pretty sure we got both the Hunter ones on.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm just saying, like, one of them missed. Just make sure that we spread out a little bit more. But that first bit looked better, so let's keep that up. Just make sure you don't get hit by the charge. Everyone's ready. Timer's going up. On that second stomp melee, the tanks are going to try to go directly towards the pillars and try to leave us a little bit of space.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Kick that shit. Bam, between him and the pillar, whoever that is, back here, run out. Let's soak again. I missed. We need to be careful with dropping those, like, rubble piles that close to the pillar also. They may have been covering up the soak.
We still had room for it.
Alright. Well, just make sure we're not missing then, because we're going to keep wiping until we soak all those.
I think Grant was talking about the split soaks because they are small enough to be completely covered by the rubble pile.
Yeah, we missed one of the small ones. I can't see through the pillar, so like I don't know which one it was. That first chain slam looked good. We just need to work on the soaks. You also need to make sure that, like, I mean, it's kind of not like the biggest deal right now since we're just learning the soaks, but you do still need to pump into Sludge Fist there.
Yeah, that, at first I was like, what the fuck? How do I? But the soaks really aren't that hard. They kind of like, I don't know. Once you
they're just fast. You don't have time to.
Yeah, you just don't have time to readjust on the second soak. Like, you just have to do it, right?
You
like,
and your partner got to be on the same wavelength there.
So when the big one splits, does it always split one to the left, one to the right?
I'm not sure if it splits exactly evenly the same time, but it should split, like, roughly the same way. If you just kind of, like I said, if you spread out a little bit from your partner, like, that way you kind of, like, mark a direction you're going to move in. Like, you, like, signal a direction you're gonna move in, and then you just get that one, basically. Sorry, I meant to do a full timer, not ready check. Aggo and Stomp's using armor kit. Let's still make sure we have all the stamina we can get. Pretty much everyone should probably just refresh their armor kit if it has like less than an hour left. So I'm just gonna. Good job on those first chain slams though. Just gotta get the soaks down and then, you know, get the movement going.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
People back here, me and Simba. We need two people.
Let me go in now. If Stubby and Simba get linked, then Chrono and his partner need to go back.
Oh, I forgot we had it assigned. I was just...
I forgot.
It's all good.
It's really hard, because... I'll try to get there. I just need to know ahead of time, because, like, not getting a combust back for a pillar is, I feel like, way worse.
No, we'll hypo if you don't.
It might be the way.
Just have Mally and his partner go back then instead. If, like, if only if Stubby and Simba are, like, linked, then Mally, you become the second group of people. Which, like, there's still no guarantee that, you know, the mages are not going to get in that, but at least hopefully that'll make it a little better. Get a battle shout for it now. Let's make sure we're just getting back quickly and getting more pulls on you guys. We just need to like see further into the fight to get the positioning down. Yeah, each pillar smash is about a minute apart. It's the hateful gazes on the RT node. I can send it again. It's 1, 2, 10, 3, 15, 4, 25, and then 5, 30. They're just slightly over a minute apart.
Because there's no point in really soul stoning a healer on this. Do you want me to soul stone a tank?
No, tank dies. It's kind of whatever. Like, it's probably okay. Good anyway.
If you're a healer, just stand up front, let the DPS move up to you.
Unless you're linked to Stubby or Simba.
Yeah.
Okay, everybody's ready.
Stay here.
Bro, they're not in front of the pillar. Between Sludge and the pillar, guys, careful. Soaks. We're still missing soaks.
I died when he hit the pillar, and there was only one guy on our side left up.
Okay.
Okay.
fight reminds me of like not exactly like the soccer boss, but like in the fact that if one person fucks up, the whole thing's alive.
Yep.
I feel like it's a lot of the fights this tier.
Well, this one in general, you just won't have the damage if someone fucks up regardless, so you can keep that in mind too, I guess. Everyone needs to do a fight regardless of whether or not.
Let's get another Ant in Battle Shout. Mally, take the spot, get a res on Val. Whoever's linked to Mally, make sure you're in the back also. Get a res on Val. Res Val. Warlock, or Death Knight.
You're gonna have to run, Val, you don't want to be over here. You really don't want to have
your
risk.
I messed that time. But I think other groups like died when he hit the pillar, so. Just make sure we're not breaking chains, guys. You gotta get to your partners right away. They have a big red arrow on their head. If you have the weak aura, it tells you who it is also.
And don't be afraid to like communicate too while we're doing the pull.
Yeah, there's like nothing to call out on this fight. So like, if you need to like be like, move. But if you know who you are linked to, you should call them out by name because they may not realize they are linked to you. So if you're like asking someone else to move, please ask them to move by name. Don't just be like move with me or move with like, you know, big, or like just be like, hey, whatever your name is, move.
It's just really bad if I have to res someone, because if the boss shares damage to that person instead of, you know, me or Grant, then that person dies immediately. So I don't want to be resing people unless I'm, you know, it's in the middle of a hateful gaze or something.
I also think we should move over here a little bit more because we did get another rumble pile there, and that was directly where the soak is. So let's try and like move more towards this gate over here. If you're standing on skull, you should. Trade me crit.
Do you want me to just put it down now?
No, we're not using another cauldron. But like, there's no point in having cauldron right now when we can't even soak the first pillar. I'm literally not worried about our DPS at all.
Need to get mechanics down. Understand them.
I literally don't even care if you attack Sludge Fist right now, to be perfectly honest. Like, we need to get past charging into the pillars.
The big thing here is just going to be mastering that first phase, because I'm pretty sure, when I was watching it, the fight is just the same throughout. Once you master the first part, it should just go down. I mean, obviously, it's not going to, but it should.
4, 3, 2, 1.
Oh my.
My bad angle.
That was entirely my bad, dude.
Does Icebound break that? So I was spamming it and didn't break it.
I chose. I don't know. He broke it the first time that I broke our chain. Like, because I was stunned and you weren't. So I don't know.
Maybe it just wasn't inputting. It didn't go on cooldown. I rebound it real quick again. LBY sometimes does that crap.
All just play tank characters and share the damage. Just all stack up.
Imagine.
The best part of the fight is at the end when on the last chain slam, I'm just gonna reset him. Careful with that in the future.
Safe.
You're dead, right? Fuck.
I don't give a fuck.
The best part of the fight is on the last chain slam. You bop whoever's the chain slam's not on, and then they kill the person that it's on purpose, and it just stops the chain slam from happening.
But what if you get like a couple of infinity?
No, because the problem is if it doesn't kill the chain slam, then the chain slam still happens, so four people have to be in it, or he gets full rage. But if the person that it's on dies, then it stops the mechanic.
Yeah, I tried to sacrifice.
I tried to turtle and run away from somebody, and I died too. I don't know.
That's fun.
Tried to do the same thing to Rice right there, it didn't work.
Yeah, I know, I died.
This fight's like the opposite of Council Guys. This is like incredibly front-loaded on learning the fight. Once you get like this soaking the pillars down, like the rest of the fight just repeats.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Come back.
Press crit. Whoever's linked to Dina is gonna have to be real careful to make sure you guys both soak.
Oh, he hit me.
Good. Now we're gonna, we're gonna move back.
Supposed to do damage there.
Yeah. That's fine. We're gonna get new links here, guys. New links. Try out a little bit.
Synchrono, we move up.
Ali, move up.
We're gonna go to the left on the stomps this time, Axie.
Okay.
We'll have to move up a little more, Crit, so we don't get the chain slam.
Me and Simba are dead, so...
Yeah, we need to get enough people in there. As long as there's four people in over here. We're gonna be going towards the pillar this time, actually. Don't get between Sludge and the pillar. Crit. Get ready to get to your spots. I know a lot of people are dead. Just try your best. Good. Alright, well, that's two pillars now. I know, like, half their raid's dead, but those soaks were good. Just wipe it now.
Did we not miss one of the small soaks on that last one?
No.
Oh, wow.
We're good?
Yeah, no, we soaked them all. It's just some people died. They're just being real low on health because we didn't have very many people alive.
Yeah, no, I just saw a bunch of people dying. I was like, oh, did we miss one? But I couldn't see if we missed one. And I didn't see any on our side.
I think we did. I'm pretty sure they all got soaked. Yeah, no, I don't see any damage from the ability that happens if you miss them. So
everybody was at like 10%, 20% health.
Yeah, we just were missing half the raid. But, I mean, that's fine. Like,
I mean,
that
that's
was
the fight.
A big improvement still. Like, that's
literally the fight.
Poggers! Poggers!
That's almost half the fight. Now it's just,
we already,
you know,
did the fight.
Doing the damage correctly while
ideally,
doing that.
Yeah, ideally we want to be past 70%, but...
Oh, yeah.
71%.
Yeah, like, no, we want to be way under that, but...
Yeah, about that.
We're missing a lot of damage, but we had a lot of people dead. And we're not using, like, full consumables right now still anyway.
Yeah, but mechanic-wise, that's the whole fight right there, literally. That's rinse and repeat.
It just gets harder at 30% because he gets more damage, but...
Yeah.
Isn't it less on, like, second pillar in Mythic, or what is it? I think it's something different, isn't it?
No, you still lost on the fourth.
Fourth pillar.
Oh, okay.
Because you have to burn
the healing, like, and all the executes and stuff.
Yeah.
You have to burn him and have everything rolling by the time he slams into the wall.
Yeah, ideally kill him before he slams into the wall, but you can get a little bit of damage out when he does slam into the wall.
Yeah.
So, once we're on the second pillar, should all the range be trying to kind of make their way over there?
Yeah, so, okay, so if you look at the picture that was in Discord with Sludge Fists, you can see the number on Sludge Fist is where he's going to be before each pillar charge. So, like, on that one, we're moving him a little bit more, so, you know, range needs to work their way towards this pillar. And then after that charge, the tanks are going to be, like, over here. And range is going to kind of want to make their way towards, like, the middle of the room towards this pillar. And then when he charges this pillar... Tanks are going all the way back out to the front here. Range wants to be spread out on the front side of the room at that point. Like, you guys have to be over here after the third pillar hit. So just make sure that you're, like, making those moves. And then for the fourth one, it's we'll have him, you know, way back here. And you guys just don't want to be in between him and the pillar, but he's going to hit this pillar and you just kind of spread out around it. And then for the fifth one, we'll be back over here, basically, and we're just going to charge him into, like, this wall.
If you have another monitor, just pull up that picture if you're ranged and you just want to make sure you know where you're going. Aggo, mute your mic.
Like, relative to the boss, you want to be around the same spot. Wraith, Atli, and Chaz use armor kits. Still want the stamina from that. Let's get an imp buff.
Back.
needs to soak with me and Dino.
If you're linked to each other, you guys are still fine. You only need two people. You just gotta do it better. Oh god, I lead. Fuck, I'm an idiot.
You're good. I stunned work that time.
Oh, we went to the same one.
You know what would be an easy way to set that up for you guys is whoever the people that are standing far out for the chain slams and the people that they're linked to, just choose the side facing the boss to hover around, left or right. Like, for example, Stubby and his partner will be left, and Simba and his partner will be to the right, and you just kind of cheat that way.
It went forward and backwards
that
one time. That
has nothing to do with the group that didn't. Like, the hunters, they're not the same group as Stubby and Simba.
Oh, I'm so sorry. But you could use that as the for the hunter group as well. Sorry.
I mean, normally there's four people there, so there's a little bit more room for error, but, like, ideally what you want to do is just spread out in within the circle, and then whoever's, you just go to the closest one to you. Like, that's what me and Axie do, because it's only ever the two of us in the tank line.
Oh yeah, I was just assigning, like, a way that they could cheat towards, so that they're spread out and able to cover the whole area.
Get a Forpo and Battle Shout. Chassis Arm Kit. Yeah, I leaped on purpose, but I leaped a little bit further than I meant to. I needed to, like, gain speed, but I went too far.
5.
Melee's, like, not making room for the tanks.
Back screwed up.
Simba's dead, so Mally, you and your partner need to be in the back. Sludge in the pillar. This one. It looks like Sludge does break any rubble that's right on the pillar, so don't be afraid to be close to the pillar early.
Yeah, Melee, if you can, when we're moving to drive the hateful gaze into the pillar. Can you guys just move to the left if you're looking at Sludge Fist? Just move over so we don't have to run over you with our circles. Give us like a little tiny gap that we can run through.
Yeah, what Gate says, by the way.
Who can try, but it's kind of hard. Like,
yeah, as long as you try.
Sometimes he goes further through the pillar than other times. Like,
as long as it's like not completely on the right side of the pillar, we should be able to reach it. So.
Oh, the only time that happened
that
time.
Where you would want it to be? Like, because you're over here.
I meant facing the entrance where we are actually facing in that phase. Sorry.
Gotcha.
So, yes. What you were thinking is correct.
How much damage is it actually, like, running over people with your circles?
Not a lot.
It's...
Just wondering how, like, cautious we really need to be when we're running through people.
In later phases, you 100% do, because there's other damage going out, but the first one is not bad.
Let's make it, like, a, you know, conscious decision that you and your partner just move a little bit.
It's 17k, like, physical damage before mitigation, which is a lot lower after mitigation, but it still hurts, so, I mean, just try not to hit each other.
Yeah, extra damage that doesn't need to be gone out.
It doesn't do anything to tanks, though. Like, we literally stand on each other and health doesn't move, but, like, I don't want to kill the melee. Like, you're not going to kill us.
This feels like Sludge Fist week one.
Just like, so you guys are aware of what happened there, he tried to avoid one of you guys.
That's what it feels like.
Got...
It feels like this fight sucks dick to be melee, and it feels like
it's just hard for me too because I don't really have
this fight
people
is
to have, like...
yeah,
it's just not going to be that good of a time.
Yeah.
I think it's totally doable. Also, it feels like I am on this mad dash to play perfect one in this fight to get enough CDR. For the first pillar. It's literally just this first pillar that feels like that. Oh, that's bad. I'm so far off here. Wait, what the fuck just killed me?
Good. Where's that
go? I'm fucking dead. Jesus fucking Christ. How?
I mean, new sets of chains here.
With me as their partner.
Is your health still looking low?
You're fucking dead, right? Oh, my pet's not there.
I missed.
Oh, there's two of them, so. Is that what happened on that one? On the first one? You just stand fucking still?
Hey, we broke 70!
Just stood there touching his thing. Also, all these people are doing their cooldowns wrong. Like, I'm about to fucking lose my mind.
Dance down, basically.
But they're not doing the fucking cooldowns properly.
I use that word intentionally to trigger PTSD from the last fight.
God, I'm
fucking... It's like 50% there, right?
If I see these fucking 2 minute classes using it on the first pillar, it's gonna drive me nuts.
During the light lost pillar, entire you get more damage, and then you also have
it's
like
just wrong. And I don't understand why people are fucking practicing the fight wrong. Like,
we're not like terribly far off. This DPS check isn't that tight.
Like I don't.
Not as it was when
I've said it. I said it twice in raid. Like, they
once
need
we're
to do it properly.
Everybody's...
Yeah, once we're using like full consumables and shit, it'll be a lot. It's just. We really gotta get this dance down because losing people is really fucking rough on this fight.
We'll have Vantus next week too.
Yeah. Unless we kill him in the next 30 minutes.
Yeah. Okay.
Throw it again.
Challenge accepted.
Yeah, damage is not a big deal right now. We can get the damage down once we can get to the Hardened Rage. Like, this is actually, I mean, like, I don't care about your damage right now. I'm not, like, just saying that.
Yeah,
we
get to all.
I actually do not care about your damage. I just want to get to the end of the fight with everyone alive.
I'm not even getting my pets out.
Yeah, if we can get to all four pillars and then die to not having enough damage, then that's great. Then we'll work on the damage once we have the mechanics down.
I think you should still try and do damage though.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah,
you should
sure.
still attempt to do damage, but I like if you focus a little bit more on mechanics right now, like that's okay.
If it's one or the other, choose mechanics.
Right, you just want to get a feel for your personal class mechanics going along
yeah.
with the boss mechanics.
You're not
yeah.
going to yell at me this next pull, right? What the fuck? Why aren't you doing damage?
Guess you guys ran around when Italia literally did that in one fight. He literally
Earth
attacked the boss once.
To have Manching Mog, because that's cool.
We gotta go.
Same with you, crit.
Oh, you like can't sprint yeah. like that, dude.
My bad.
Person need to be back.
That was really far back, Simba, so we're gonna have to run.
I was trying to do the first time.
It's hard because I have to Wraithwalk or I won't make it.
I think we missed there.
Yeah, we did.
The first one was good though. Dude, I didn't even die to you breaking my chain. Like, I didn't use a cheat death. I think I was meta'd, so it just like all went to armor. I just did like zero damage. Which is insane because it's 250k before mitigation and it didn't pop a cheat death.
Yeah, it didn't pop mine either. But I popped the.
I was gonna say I thought I saw your Phoenix on cooldown, but I don't know.
Maybe it did. Maybe it did.
But yeah, I was mad at it. It didn't kill me. I was like, oh.
So this fight, what
has to say.
two minutes are on pull.
Vengeance
so you do
yeah,
2 minutes
chain.
On pull. Second
I'm
pillar.
Glad Vengeance Demon Hunter is
fourth
so
pillar.
Good right now because
fourth pillar
bad
is lust.
For a long time,
okay, so. You do 4 minutes.
They need some
pull.
Time.
Fourth pillar, with lust. You do 3 minutes. First
this
pillar.
This fight's just really good
third,
for Vengeance
fourth
because
pillar.
The downtime is
okay.
Like just enough to, for everything to cycle back up. So like I always have cooldowns.
Yeah, I mean then 1 minute's obviously just every fucking pillar, you know, 45 seconds every pillar, stuff like that. But like on pull right here, the Boomkins should be blowing their shit off. The Windwalker should be doing his stuff. Like I should see everybody's cooldowns because everybody has 2 minutes basically in our raid group. Like almost all of them are 2 minute glasses.
Which
and so,
we
should just be crushing that one. Like, the only person who shouldn't be CDing on pole, I think, is probably Stubby. I'd have to check Ellie. I don't know Ellie. Ellie might be different, but Stubby, the Warlock, is not on pole.
How do we all go back? We all end up back one.
It's just about a minute. Slightly over a minute.
If you don't, you won't have them up for the lust.
The first pillar, though.
Yeah, you want to use 2 minutes on pull, and then 2 minutes on the second pillar, and then 2 minutes on the fourth pillar.
Oh, it's almost like I said that 4 fucking times.
And yeah, you guys, like, once he's doing Hateful Gaze, you guys need to, like, move towards the pillar. Just don't be in between Sludge and the pillar. But you need to be ready to soak, like, pretty much right away.
Yeah.
You can't do like fast, like unpredictable movement, so you need to make your way there.
Yeah, I can't believe we all went back. I guess like was saying, I think the way to fix the hunt one, even if there's 4 or 2 people, like one of the groups.
That literally word for word what I've said 3 times.
Right.
Like
yeah, that's so if Axie come over here. Dumb. If you look at what me and Axie do, basically, our circle's here. We just kind of pick 2 different directions of the circle, and then you just go to where everyone's closest to you. So, like, they either split, like, this way or this way, but you're closer to one than the other person. And the range soak should have a lot more people in it. There's 6 people in the melee soak. 4 people in the hunter soak for 10, 12, or 2 in the tank soak for 12. There should be 8 people in the range soak, which is Skull on the first pillar. It should be everyone that's not linked to the hunters that is ranged. Should just be on this Skull, and then you split out and soak the 2, however you want. But you guys need to be getting ready to soak, and like when we go to the second pillar, it's the same position, so the range soak is this diamond. So you need to make sure, like, when he's gonna hit the pillar, you know, you can't be, like, here because he'll hit you, but you can be, like, here and he won't hit you, and then you just, like, step into it.
Well, recklessness is 1.5, right? And then, no, I'm not sure. I can't say. For certain. I'd have to check Warrior. I can check it, though. Well, okay, these people aren't even playing properly, so... Let me find it real quick. Well, let me check Warrior specs in general. So you're actually supposed to play anger management on this one? I thought so. And that's so that you can get a recklessness on every pillar. So you're going to be playing with recklessness on every pillar by using anger management instead of the other one.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Press can. Go further than you're not between the boss and the pillar, but be ready to soak. Ready to soak as soon as he hits.
No, you use Signet with recklessness.
And second soaks.
With anger management. Good. It's actually, I think, even better with it. I think it's even better because you get more recklessnesses off. So you want to use Signet on this fight because it's a burst fight. Yeah, so what you're going to do is you're going to recklessness on pull. Bladestorm on pull. Alright. I think recklessness with anger management should be under a minute, so you might bladestorm then recklessness. I'm not sure. I'd have to check the. I'd have to like really go into the lore so I can do that though.
So I'm gonna leap to the other side of the rubble, but not very far.
So yeah, but once you're done with that, you're going to then every pillar, you're going to recklessness and then bladestorm on the pillars. And then the signet's gonna go off twice on each pillar, hopefully giving you an avatar,
that, like,
the mini
blood,
all
pillar.
Of it. Like,
okay.
It was like half the group's not over there, so.
Yeah, it's. They can, like, walk into it, though. Like, it'll last. There's no damage after he hits the pillar, so, like, it's mainly just to help mitigate.
Okay, yeah, now I'll get it in there.
And if, like, you can kind of try to get it, like, between two of the groups so they can be on the edge of it, that might help a little bit. Probably the ranged and the hunter group, because otherwise it's going to be where Sludge is charging. So if you just drop it, like, on this corner of the pillar.
I mean, I don't think but the other pillar you guys will necessarily be there anytime soon. I mean, you'll probably be there in a couple of weeks. But, you know, I'm
up there, even on the...
Definitely once you get here, you'll
probably, just go to
probably
pillar.
Figure out exactly how you're just doing it. It's really easy
I was still running up
to
here,
figure
like,
out the DPS cooldowns for this fight. Like
here,
they're crystal clear because the fight is, like, really scripted. So you know exactly when to use
it. The charge damage.
And that's part of what's tilting me right now is that, like, all of these people should be able to know this when they're supposed to use
the
cooldown. I mean, one, just fucking common sense would say it, but it's just tilting, dude.
They do almost nothing.
Like, just fucking...
We're gonna be careful not to... Oops. Not to set it on top of the
I mean, I guess people just aren't paying attention, which I understand. Like, people are just kind of chilling. But it's kind of like, oh, man, like... Just fucking practice the way you're supposed to fight. Like, I'm full cooldowns the whole fight.
We've always had rest, so
because when we get it, I don't want to then have to try and figure out how to DPS it. Like, I want to learn it all at once instead of trying to learn, I'm going to learn the mechanics, and then, oh, now I'm going to learn the damage. Like, no, I'm going to learn the mechanics while everybody learns them. And then we're already going to know the damage because we did that while we were figuring out the mechanics. You know. At least that's my approach to this. Like, all through council, I was trying to figure out the CD timings.
Yeah, but...
It really is my inner raid leader fucking crying. You're right. Just crying in the fucking
corner. I need you to start paying attention to every detail of the game, okay?
4, 3, 2, 1
And how through is the different worlds in this game? I'm gonna go around that, like, shit to the right.
Alright.
Chasma bug?
Go back. Dude, you can make that chain real big.
I know, I thought
you were- I went the, like, other way, and I was like, oh god.
I was a little scared.
Good. Big peeps.
Simba can't get the soak in the back.
Get him.
Bring it at the left, get out of the stomp here.
It's with them anyway, so.
Yeah, that happens if people are dead and shit's uneven. So, make sure we get 4 people in the range group on there. Try to get 4 people on that. I missed.
Over here.
I missed the chain slam.
Yeah.
Does that hit differently depending on how close you are?
Just what?
Those little spike things. Sometimes they hit like just as you can in a one house with Kesma. I think so.
Our damage is
actually more than one. Everyone was really stacked up on one of them, like it's...
Our damage was actually on kind of on par there. 59% for the third pillar.
Put some people down too, so that was good.
Yeah.
Yeah, damage is not gonna be the issue here, we just gotta get through, like, the fight with everyone alive. So for that third pillar, like, we would have had more time. There was another stomp. Like, we didn't, he shouldn't have charged there. We missed the chain slam. and that's why he got full energy.
Oh.
But you do need to start moving towards this pillar after the first and second stomp, after he hits the second pillar. Like, when he hits the second pillar, range doesn't want to spread back out this way. Range wants to spread out, like, this way, towards, like, the middle of the room. Because we're going to have him, like, here. And then you'll spread out this way. And then when he hits this pillar, the tanks are coming over here. So range wants to get, like, in the front of the room over here. Well, not that close, because that's melee range. But, like, you know, here. And then he's going to charge this pillar. And then we'll be pulling him, like, here. And it's kind of just, like, get somewhere you can. That there won't be a lot of space at that point. That's the hard part of the fight.
Excuse me.
That is way more fun than council.
Yeah, I enjoy this fight, actually.
It's alright.
It's like, because it's short.
The one fight mage is actually insane at, and you say it's alright? Okay. Okay.
5, 4,
hard to please.
3, I hate this class.
2,
hard to please.
1.
Does everyone have to stack on me? Why the fuck are the range moved up?
Like, murdered the melee there.
Yeah.
Like, just create a wall. I mean, I fucking... How much overkill was it?
Another group get in.
Sorry. It wasn't your fault. Like, accidentally wheeled a different way than me.
I didn't have a training partner, so it was like.
You normally go left, so I just thought we were going left. My bad.
So the only way you don't get a chain partner is if someone's dead, right?
Correct. If there's an uneven number of people alive, then somebody won't be chained.
Yeah, sorry, I should have said something earlier. I need to change one of my keybinds because it's fucking me up.
We're stuck.
Oh,
point. So night can be over already.
We'll still get no.
So sweet to squish you with my.
Sorry about that.
I'm just gonna go around and look at everybody's shit. That's all I'm gonna do. Holy fuck, we can slap on this fight. Cast time on. Losing an entire cast and win 99 percentile parts.
Let's get Ant Battle Chat. Just waiting for you, Chris. You and your partner need to be in the back. Fine, just get started behind everybody else.
Save my sneakers.
I'm gonna go right for this one because Stomp's gonna go into the wall.
Crit died, so two people need to get in the back.
The boss this way. Melee can hit him.
No. Thank you, Chaz, for not doing that.
What?
I have freedom.
I hate this fucking fight so goddamn fucking much.
Is that
I hate that fucking chain. Wish I had a fucking bot to play with.
Sorry, forget that it's Mally. I'll try and say Mally.
God, my fucking streamers aren't like poo poo. Holy shit.
Just gonna take some time for everybody to get used to it, but hopefully, once we kinda get it down tight on the first pillar, it'll click for all the rest of them.
The three groups are in that pull. Does it extend how long it takes for the charge?
No.
So there's no, yeah. Just more damage.
It's just more damage to heal, yeah. because it puts out more chain bleeds. The only time he gains extra rage is if it's less than four people.
So I'm getting wrecked this whole fight.
Yeah, because you have the chain bleed on you.
Is that why boomkins are the choice usually, or is that?
Yep. They're also good because they can like bear form as they get pulled and take less damage when they get slapped. Dara's either of them, though. On each of them, like the number of players.
Stay here.
You fuck this shitty fight.
Sometimes it's weird. Not even close to it.
Yeah, I don't know. Just that, yes.
Kesma, you gotta make sure you're there. I don't wanna be there.
Worth. At least you don't take durability like from the chain shatter. Like it's why you just shatter your chains.
I was chained there at the end with Bell when we went to fight.
Yeah, that's because this fucking fight sucked. That's why it looks like it's gonna suck. It looks like it's gonna suck because this fight fucking blows. Like, I
might have died like before it broke.
God, it's annoying.
Because if they die to something else, it doesn't shatter.
Straight up not having a good time. I was having a better time on council. At pull like 80 or 90 or whatever. Fuck it.
Where at? Bad.
I was having a way better fucking time than I am right now.
Ghost Wolf and Ankh Totem, and we'll just not have to do chains every time.
Jesus, man. Chains now. Boom. Dead. Fucking range. Silk around the end. Boom. Dead. Remember they used all this shit, and then everybody began to read on how to use their DPS cooldowns.
Bring up
great
like
fucking
people?
Time. I'm looking forward to it.
Me I should neck myself.
If I sound happy, I hope I sound happy. I liked Kills. This is the boss I'm gonna hate.
No comment? Okay.
This is the only boss in the instance I fucking hate. And I fucking hate it with all my heart. I think it's legit the worst boss. And it's not even close. It's trash.
Thank you.
start going after.
Why'd you roll? What was that? Just come to the fucking side we gotta stand on.
Alright. Scrub it up. It's not bad for tonight.
I'm fucking.
Made some progress and Sludge. Really good job on council kill. It's a nice clean pull. The
time wow,
kill.
Yeah, I'm fucking so goddamn happy
please
right now.
Please take the time to watch a Sludge Fist video.
Oh my god. Tuesday. Take roll off your bar. Take charge off your bar. Take all fucking force movement off your goddamn bar.
Anytime we're going to a new fight, you need to make sure that you know like the basic mechanics of what's different on Mythic and like the general strategy. But we still made some solid progress, so just come back on Tuesday and we'll work with some more on Solid Twist.
Fucking hate this goddamn boss.
Yep, if you're still needing certain pieces, best in slots, whatever, make sure you're doing your keys for the week because you're not going to have a vault for raid. So don't rely on that.
If we ever.
I mean, yeah, there's some good pieces still.
Yeah. Yeah, why didn't I just press roll with him? I almost reacted in time, too. I almost did it. I moved in the direction, it was just too far. Like, I saw him do it. I was like, he's gonna fucking roll.
I can't stop burping. I don't know what's
if he'd rolled to the pillar.
So bad.
It sounded like a growl. Dude, okay. I thought someone growled at me.
Just, God, okay. Don't press fucking roll. Just don't do it. Just don't fucking do it.
Oh my god. Good job tonight, guys.
Just don't.
See you later.
GG.
Dino's pet.
Alright guys, well, thanks for watching, Pole. You know, be back at it like a crack addict next week. Probably stream some stuff later. But yeah.
So how's everybody doing
tonight? Here goes the stream. Big fucking council prompt. I hate that I had to fucking do that boss afterwards, because I knew it was going to ruin my night. Nothing like killing a mythic boss and literally hating your fucking life because you're having to do fucking Sludge Fist as a melee. This fight is not that hard. I don't think it's even gonna take that long. I think people are gonna figure it out and it's gonna be okay, but it's just so goddamn miserable. I hate it.
I just need lots of melee.
I hate it so goddamn much.
We should be final next week.
But good night, guys.
Are other people?